What I've been up to, Dan Reeder Newsletter number 3. I was sort of window shopping online recently when I came across this. Look at those gorgeous colored pencils. Oh man, I thought, if I had that, I could make really cool pictures. That's not how it actually works, of course. What actually happens is you lose a couple of them. Some of them you use a lot, they get short. They're never in the right order. You drop some of them. That breaks the lead so you can't ever sharpen them. In short, they'll never look this good again. And nothing you draw with them will ever look as beautiful as this photo of them. But you don't know that yet, and that's how they get you. I recently watched a TikTok video where a guy explains how to calculate how many possible orders a deck of cards can be in. He says it's 52 cards in the deck, so 52 times 51 times 50 times 49 times 48 and so on. He says the number you get is bigger than the number of atoms in the universe. And because that number is so big, if you shuffle a deck of cards, it's entirely possible that no deck of cards has ever been in that order before, ever in the history of the world. Okay, it was a TikTok video, between Jiggly This and Puppy That, so I don't know how seriously we should take it, but huge numbers are weird. Take the lottery. These are last week's winning numbers. 2, 24, 25, 27, 28, 45, and the extra number was 4. These are perfectly normal numbers, nothing exotic. I feel like I've known them all my life. All you have to do is pick the right 6. How hard can it be? When you go into a lottery shop, there's a sign telling you exactly how hard it can be. The chances of getting it right are 139 million to 1, which is a number you can't imagine. What you can imagine is either you win or you don't, which is 50-50, and that's how they get you. So why am I talking about colored pencils and the lottery? I recently bought a new MIDI keyboard. I regretted it immediately. I didn't really need it. My old one still worked. Though I have to say, when MIDI keyboards get old, especially the ones with the piano hammer mechanism, they start to sound like a bowling alley. So if you're playing and singing, you get a lot of clackety-bonk on the voice track. There's an easy workaround. You just play it once with the piano, and then you mute the original voice and sing it again. But as we learned from the colored pencil example, we are easily fooled by shiny things and bright colors. So I bought it. There's another side to it, though, and I think that's why guys buy new guitars all the time. They think maybe I can play that one, but that's a whole nother subject. I researched the MIDI keyboards before I bought mine, and maybe that's why I felt like they had tricked me. Let's look at the descriptions. They all promise, quote, seamless integration with your DAW, unquote. So what does DAW mean? It stands for Digital Audio Workstation. What word seems out of place here? I'm going to do hard work on my audio workstation. I don't know about these other guys, but I'm not going to be working. I'm going to be fucking around. The integration thing, yeah, that is kind of nice. Not perfect. I still need a keyboard and a mouse, but it's nice. The other thing they promise is, quote, improved workflow, unquote. There's that word again. I didn't even know I had a workflow. What it means is that instead of reaching for your mouse and clicking on the button, you just push the button on the keyboard. I feel like they tricked me. You save a half a second, but they're suggesting that that's what's been holding you back all this time. With this new improved workflow, you'll be able to put out tons of super good new music. Of course, workflow was never the problem. The problem is that you're sitting in front of a blank canvas, and the job is to fill it with something that has meaning. You can't buy a solution to that, but you want to believe you can, and that's how they get you. But now for something happy. Do you remember when it was nice to buy?